If reality wasn't real, how long would it take you to realize that reality? That's the question at the heart of the problem at the top of today's video. And the answer requires a major existential rethink. Forget everything you thought you knew, all the memories you thought you had, and even all the knowledge you thought you held about simulation theory itself, because we could yet be many, many planes away from the truth. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, is modern life simulated by an ancient civilization?
Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content.
It doesn't always happen that a genuine scientific cosmological theory blends in so well with science fiction thought experiments and manages to retain its own credibility. But that's exactly what has happened with the simulation hypothesis. And while it was famously put forward in its modern guise by the Swedish thinker Nick Bostrom, it's a dramatic line of inquiry that actually dates back centuries, to René Descartes in particular, who said it was perhaps impossible to, quote, clearly distinguish wakefulness from sleep. Descartes was famously interested in getting to the bottom of what is and what was real, laying the groundwork for simulation theory, one of the most contemporary approaches to that question. Nick Bostrom took up the mantle in 2003 upon the release of his paper titled Are You Living in a Simulation? Published in the journal Philosophical Quarterly. In the years and decades since then, the idea has garnered yet more high-profile backers, not least Elon Musk, who said on the Joe Rogan Experience that he felt it was, quote, most likely that there are, quote, many, many simulations, and Neil deGrasse Tyson, who has suggested that the odds that we're living in a sim should be at least 50-50. Bostrom's original argument rests largely on the assumption that one of three propositions must be true. Either one, humankind will most likely go extinct before reaching a post-human level, or two, that any possible post-human civilization is also unlikely to build and run ancestor sims, as though that unlikelihood in itself were a shared characteristic, and three, we are almost certainly living in a simulation right now. In this way, we either die out before it's possible to make a sim, and the same goes for every other group, or the making of a sim just isn't something that advanced groups do, or it is something that they do, and therefore it's extremely probable that we're in one. With that third one, the statistical probability is really the key, because if ancestor sims are possible at all in this reality, then the chances that we will be the first to achieve them are so slim they're almost zero. And therefore, the chances that we are simply one of a potentially infinite number contained within one are so high, they're almost one. But is an ancestor sim even possible from the outset? Bostrom argues that yes, it is. As a preamble for his main theory, he describes how the computing power of advanced groups could far, far outstrip our own. By crunching the numbers for a hypothetical, Matryoshka brain-style, planet-sized supercomputer, and by estimating the computing requirements of the human mind, Bostrom arrives at the staggering conclusion that the potential of a future computer could make it possible, quote, to simulate the entire mental history of humankind by using less than 1/1,000,000th of its processing power for 1 second, end quote. If there's anything to make you feel small and insignificant, then it's probably that. Bostrom suggests that not only everything you are, but everything that everyone is and ever has been collectively, might also be achievable for a computer in only slightly more than the blink of an eye. And so with all of that in mind, where could or would an ancient civilization come into the equation? Naturally, we aren't here considering ancient civilizations within recorded history, or even of Earth. If Earth as we know it really were a sim, then whoever's created it would clearly not exist on it. While to us it's home, planet Earth to them is more like an open-world video game. The ancient Egyptians, the Sumerians, the early humans of the Stone Age, they're all simply earlier stages of that game, just as we today are only the latest installment. Again, it's enough to make you feel very, very small. The ancient civilization's simrunners, however, are bigger than all of that and all of us, because they are the ones that are busily rendering our reality, as though in the background. Although not in the sense that we could ever hope to uncover them, because they literally exist beyond what's physically possible from our point of view, and are incomprehensible to us. Although, in fact, some interpretations of simulation theory do link this fundamental unknowability back up into our own existence, by, for example, suggesting that microscopic phenomena wouldn't need to be consistently there, so long as nothing is appreciably absent to those living within the sim. i.e. us. Bostrom himself highlights this, writing that our hypothetical sim runners need only to make it so that simulated humans, quote, interacting in normal human ways, don't notice any irregularities. A similar argument could be made as to why the wider universe is always so inevitably distorted from our position, too. We know the other stars and planets are there, but we can't know them in detail because they've never been created in detail, because they've never been that important to the sim that we're in. It follows, then, that the sim runners would need a vast and specific understanding of some seemingly very complex ideas, like what makes a universe, what shapes life experience, and what are the limits to any one being's knowledge. For this reason, it could well be that they are ancient within their own level of reality. They must certainly have had some kind of in-depth experience in order to have even the imagination to conceive of all of this, all of our own lives into being, let alone the supreme technical know-how to actually make it happen. Indeed, that assumption is somewhat wrapped up in their post-human moniker. But then again, another interpretation could be that on their level, the universe as we know it is actually quite a basic design, in which case they perhaps need not be quite so ancient after all. That part of today's question remains especially up for debate. To finish, though, Bostrom leads us to yet another paradigm-shifting realization towards the end of his paper, suggesting that, quote, it may be possible for simulated civilizations to become post-human as well. He goes on to describe such developments, effective simmed sims, as having to play themselves out on virtual machines. That is, as though on an unreal computer from the point of view of the base reality. But from there, with Bostrom also revealing that virtual machines can be stacked, there's really no end to how many times this same process could be repeated over and over and over again. Our own potentially ancient simulators could then have their own potential ancient simulators, who then have their own, and so on. Quite where the hypothetical chain would end, quite when we'd reach the absolute fundamental bottom base reality, is intrinsically unknown. Although Bostrom argues that if we ourselves ever develop simulated realities, then we would therefore have to conclude that we live in a simulation too. Again, the chances of us being the first to achieve it are just so incredibly far-fetched. So what's your verdict? Is this a sim? Are our sim runners a sim? Are their simulators a simulated invention too? If the simulation hypothesis were ever proven to be irrefutably correct, how far would you go back before you were satisfied that you'd landed at the base camp for literally everything? For now, and even if this world is actually only a steady stream of seriously sophisticated code, there's a lot of life to live within it. Ancestor program or not, there are experiences everywhere to be had, to enjoy, and to remember. That's how modern life might be simulated by an ancient civilization, but it's still ours alone to make the very most of.
What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled. And make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.